Betty, it's Dizzy, and I've got kind of a product roundup for you guys. Just some things I've been trying and really liking, and a couple things I haven't liked so much. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go ahead and start with the stuff that didn't work for me, and then the rest of the video will be all positive. So the first thing that didn't work for me is the Smoky Extravagant Makeup Forever Mascara. I got a sample of this, and I finally got around to trying it. And the main problem with it is, can you see this brush? This brush is gigantic. So I'll try to use it, and I've got very short eyelashes and kind of smaller eyes, and it will just get everywhere. I mean, it'll get like on up here and down here, and you can't even remotely use it for your bottom lashes. I don't know. I think if you had the right eye shape, it would be nice. If I bother to use it, it does give me tons of volume. But it's just not worth it for me to have to like clean up so much after it. So that's that one that I didn't like. And then I've got another mascara I didn't like. And the next two things are both things that were from an Ipsy bag. So I used this one time. This is the City Color Be Bold 3x Volume and Length Mascara. So my problems with this were, this brush is crazy. Do you see the spiraliness? It is so spiky, it'll like poke you right in the eye. I felt like those spiky bristles made my eyelashes clump together, so it looked like I had about 5 eyelashes. They didn't look longer, they didn't look better. They looked really black, so I'll give it that. It's a very, very black formula, but it really didn't make the most of my eyes. And then when I removed it, it flaked, and it flaked directly into my eye, so it was really painful and irritating, and it actually itched a lot while I was on, and it had some flakes and fallout under my eyes when I was wearing it, so I don't recommend that. And then another Ipsy bag fail is the JCat Beauty Makeup of the Day Waterproof Slide-On Pencil for Eyes in the color Bronze. So there's the pencil, and it's a twist up, but it doesn't really twist up that well. And then this is the color, and like it just crumbled and broke. So you can, and now I'm trying to get more of it out, and yeah, that's not gonna happen. It just doesn't come up. And the color is really nice, but it's not very good. Like once it's on, it doesn't really come off and transfer, but it was hard to remove, which is fine for a waterproof pencil, but it was hard to get it to actually show up on my eye. It swatched fine on my hand, but I had to really push to get it to show on my eye, and I'm just not into that. So enough of that. Let's see the stuff I am into. So I'll start with eyebrows. I have been really enjoying either two different eyebrow looks. Either this one, which is a bit more full on, and this is done with the NYX Eyebrow Gel in Espresso. It's a little too dark for me, but it's been really fun to play with, and I really like the eyebrow gel. I think I want to get a different color of that, but it stays on forever. It's so nice. And then what I've been doing is putting this over it. This is Fantasy Makers by Wet n Wild Color Mascara, and it's the pink one. And this is like their Halloween collection, but you see it's like, it's pink. And I've just been like brushing that on kind of the front of my brow. And it kind of gives it just like a hint of pink, so it matches my hair a little better. And that's been really fun on like full on makeup days. And then for days when I want to just look a little bit more natural, this is an Ipsy bag giveaway that I got a long time ago that I'll probably repurchase when I'm done with this. This is the Chella Eyebrow Pencil in Tantalizing Taupe. It's got a nice fine tip. And there's the color. Just a really nice soft taupe color. And you can go really light with it, just very light strokes. But it's wonderful for just filling in the tail or just brushing on just a little bit on your eye and not having it look too crazy. So this has been great for natural days. Let's see. I think we'll go into eyeshadows and eye products. The number one thing I have been using, I'm wearing it today, I've been wearing it pretty much every day, is the Natural Matte Palette from Too Faced. It is the matte shadow version of the Too Faced Natural Palette. I love it. Today I'm wearing lace teddy all over with a little bit of strapless and risque. I used a little bit of Sixpresso to darken up around the lash line and Heaven. But I've used all these colors. They're all beautiful. They work really well together. And if you just want a soft, quick eye look, it is amazing. And then I also used today, I don't know if you guys can see, that little hint of green, and that is this NYX Jumbo Pencil in Rocky Mountain Green. It is just a really pretty color. Like, look, isn't that a lovely emerald color? You can kind of blend it out a little bit and make it more smudgy, or you can wear it full strength. Like I said, I used it just kind of smudged around as an eyeliner today. I don't even know if you can see it, but you see that little bit of green right there? That's where it is, and I've loved that. And then the other color I've been using that's another jumbo pencil is Rust. And it is so fall appropriate. So there is Rust. It's like that Marsala kind of color. It's just really beautiful and very, very fall. I love it. While we're talking about pencil type products, really quickly, I have found my new favorite pencil sharpener for cosmetics pencils. I have a tendency for mine to break off or crack or really do terrible things to my pencils. But this is the NYX sharpener, and it's just been spectacular. I highly recommend it. It's definitely worth a look. I've had people tell me that it's a very good dupe for the Urban Decay Grindhouse, which I don't have, but had pondered getting if this didn't work. So I was really happy that this worked, and I saved some serious moolah. All right, blush. I've been using the same combination of blush all for the last couple months. It's right there. And what this is the Milani Romantic Rose Blush. Looks like that. My lighting just went crazy. But it's just, there's a concentrated swatch. Really soft kind of mauvey brown color. And then with it, over it, or sometimes just by itself, I have been using the Maybelline Master Studio Master Highlight in the color Nude. And I just swirl it. And there it is right there, that kind of champagne-y color. But I really, really like this powder. I'm using it, that glow you see on my cheeks today is that. So it's been really nice. I'm just grabbing a paper towel because I've got like swatch-a-go-go happening. And speaking of swatch-a-go-go, I'm getting ready to show you guys a bunch of my favorite lipsticks right now. So I'm gonna start with the combo that I'm wearing today. I have the NYX Lip Liner in Earth Tone. There's Earth Tone right there. So it's very much a brown. It's straight up brown lip liner. It's very 90s. But then I'm wearing with that this Maybelline lipstick in Deepest Cherry. So there's Deepest Cherry. And then I've got over the top of that and a lot of other things this month or last couple months is Nomad from OCC, and it's a stained gloss. Now, I feel a little bad showing you this, but you can still get it on the OCC website. They are discontinuing it though, but it's just a gorgeous, gorgeous color. So there's a concentrated swatch of Nomad, but it's this beautiful color. You can wear it alone. You can wear it over your lipsticks. I'm wearing it over this red to make it look a little bit more brown. There's it a little bit more sheared out so you can see some of the golden tones to it. But yeah, it's just beautiful. Another OCC color that I really enjoy, so if you have a chance to get it or you have it and you just haven't used it in a while, take it out and have a look at it, is Strumpet. I have been wearing Strumpet a lot, so I'll show you guys what Strumpet looks like. So there's Strumpet. I think you might be able to get Strumpet in the new format. I'm not 100% sure. But there it is. That's Strumpet. It's just a beautiful wine color. So very, very pretty. And the OCC Lip Tars are just, they're spectacular. They last all day. I've been really into that wine color, so I've also been wearing the LA Girl Matte Flat Finish Pigment Gloss in the color Rebel. So there is that. And there's a swatch of Rebel, and you can see it's just a little darker and more purpley than Strumpet is. And this is interesting, it's the only one of these I have, and they have a really nice kind of soft feel to them on the lips. They do get sticky at first and then they dry down, and I usually have to put, much like the OCC Lip Tars, I have to put some sort of hydrating gloss over them later in the day or they're just too dry. But I like the colors and I do like the formula. And then a variation on that color that's a little bit more everyday wear friendly is the NYX Butter Lipstick in Licorice. So that is Licorice, and I love that color. Just a really beautiful wine burgundy. But like I said, it's just a little bit more wearable than the darker ones were in the more matte formula. And then finally, just some more natural colors that I've been wearing a lot. One is Summer Sunset. I'll put that right here. It's just, it's a little peachy, it's a little reddish. But it's mostly a neutral, and this is a Maybelline color. It's Maybelline Summer Sunset, and I just think it's an awesome color. I could just wear this without any other makeup and it looks good. And then another color that's very similar to that is from the Maybelline Matte Collection, and it's Touch of Spice. And as you can see, Touch of Spice is a little deeper because it's a matte and a little bit pinkier and less warm, but really pretty. And then the other color, it's my classic, it's the NYX Butter Lipstick in Pops. And Pops is just nude perfection that I could wear like every day. So that concludes the makeup part of things. I did have a couple other things I wanted to talk about really quickly. There are three video games that I've been playing on my iPad exhaustively. So the first one is the Bubble Witch 2 game, and if you remember Bust a Move, Bubble Witch is pretty much Bust a Move with super adorable little witch characters and her kitty cats as like her little helpers. So it's a really cute game. It's totally awesome and you should try it. And then there's 10-10, which is like if you took Tetris and you made, if you took like the board that Tetris is played on, and then you got to actually, instead of the tiles dropping and you move them, you actually got to just put them where you want them on the board. And you have to try to match as many rows and lines as you can before you run out of moves. And then finally, the last one is Two Dots, which is a really cool strategy game where you match colored dots. And that sounds simple, but it actually gets pretty complicated pretty quick. So there we go. That is my favorites for like September / early October. I hope that you guys enjoyed this video. Please thumbs up if you did. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you next time.